So what's new this week?
Galangal and turmeric.
This is galangal. Different looks.
Spicy ginger? It looks different.
Tastes different too.
Yeah. So those were the two new things this week. Is there anything else new? Right now it's like we got everything under the sun. All the summer stuff and all the winter and fall stuff. Friday was a zoo. Yeah, Peter. Everybody and their brother was at the stand, which was great. Great feeling. Other than that, nope, we have everything. Everything from basil, which is strange this time of year. Artichokes are still coming in. But I think our imminent frost is Monday. So we'll see how that goes. Pray for us. We don't really want a frost. On the other hand, that kind of puts us out of our misery. Everything freezes. We can rest and plan for next year. But on the other hand, it's nice to have something to sell. So it's been a great run. No complaints. The turmeric did very well this year. One of our plants yielded 3 pounds, which, like the last time I grew it, one plant didn't yield anything, literally. Here's where I'm going, Peter.
You want to ride?
Yeah.
So what's it like transitioning from the summer months of nonstop to just slowing down?
Well, it's like, again, it's like one of those, it's like you really don't want it to freeze because you need to sell stuff, you need the income. But on the other hand, you're so exhausted that, you know, once the frost happens, it's like a relief because it just cuts down way down on the amount of work that we do. And we've got guys working 80, 100 hours, I work 100 plus hours a week. And so it's a relief when the frost, the killing frost finally happens. And a killing frost is different than, just it going down to 32 degrees doesn't really kill stuff. You gotta have 28 degrees for at least 4 hours. And that kills stuff off.
Really?
Yes. So Monday is forecast to be, I think it's 33, but that's in the city of Norwich and we're generally 3 to 4 degrees colder. If it's a overcast night, we probably won't get a heavy frost. If it's raining, that mitigates some of the frost. If it's a clear night, that's when you get those really nasty frosts.
Yeah.
So we don't know. We'll have to see. Everybody's a bit on edge. There's still a lot of crops out there that we could sell, summer crops, but we're on borrowed time as it stands now. So and then it also means that the guys are out there trying to harvest stuff ahead of the frost, and so it's a frenzy. It's a literal frenzy right now. And we had this frenzy, a week ago, 10 days ago, when they forecasted the frost that didn't happen?
Yeah.
And in our case, we have the high tunnel, so we'll go throw temporary heaters in some of our high tunnels because the weather forecast after Monday looks beautiful again for the next 10 days. So the guys are going to try, they're going to cover the plants up, they're going to, put little heaters in the high tunnels on sensitive stuff, they're going to harvest stuff, they're going to do whatever they can to basically maximize our harvest and minimize the damage from a frost. Of course, you got things like, the winter stuff, the frost doesn't damage them. If anything, it makes them taste better, such as Brussels sprouts and parsnips and those type of things. Kale, yeah, all your cold hardy stuff starts tasting better when after the first frost, especially if it's a good, nice, good, nice frost, as opposed to just dropping down to 30, 32 for a week or something like that. So that's the news from Lake Wobegon, or in our case, Norwich. And stay tuned to what happens after Monday. And I'll be back home on Monday, so I'll witness it firsthand.
What's it like to go from this level of concentration of people to going back on the farm?
Well, it is a welcome reprieve because we are used to quiet, calm and quiet. Even though the pace of the farm far exceeds any pace you've ever seen in New York City, but at least we can hear the birds chirping up there. And there's not a million sirens. And at night, you can actually hear the crickets. So I love going home, Peter.
Are you doing a documentary?
No place. Yeah, he is.
For real? Oh, he is. Oh.
Yeah, he's documenting.
Where you gonna play this on, man? HBO?
Yeah. You never know.
It's on YouTube.
Oh.
It's on YouTube now.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
What you search for? Norwich Meadow?
Yeah, Norwich Meadows Farms Market Update. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Peter Shapiro.
No, you're not joking though, it's for real.
Yeah.
I've been doing it since June.
I'm gonna look it up tonight, man.